What did we do before explainable AI? From 1958 until 2015, everyone in the US was using logistic regression models for credit scoring because we had regulatory requirements that mandated that we give explanations derived directly from the models themselves. Starting in 2015, Matt and many other smart people figured out how we can actually generate explanations from neurodecision models. Moving into 2017, we were then able to expand that concept to other techniques like gradient boosting machines, decision trees, random forest models, opening up a lot of new doors for us. And now here we are in 2019, we've taken the next step. Those solutions to that point were what I would call static models, that it's an AI technique, but you're building a model, you're putting it into production, you're monitoring performance of that solution, and when you see performance deterioration or over some certain time period, you decide, I'm going to build a new model. You go back, build a new model, put it into production again, and you start that process over. With adaptive AI, we actually put a process into production as opposed to a single model in which, as we're getting new data over time, the new data are cycling through this process, and the model is essentially self-updating and then being pushed back into production. So we're ensuring that we have the fully optimized model in production at any given point in time.
The old way of doing things where you build a model and then you submit it to a manual review, this could be an extensive process, but now we build out these guardrails and say, if you stay within these guardrails, then this model is approved for usage. And that's what allows us to make these frequent automated updates because the models are not allowed to go outside the guardrails.
One key point to add is that these models will never be completely turned loose to just self-update and push back into production. There's always going to be some level of human interaction that you execute a model update, it's going to go into a review dashboard. It's more of a streamlined review where you say, were the correct guardrails applied to this model? Were there any errors when this process executed? And then does the model perform significantly better than the model I currently have before deciding I'm going to push a deploy button and now push this new model into production? Ultimately, it gets down to improving the lives of the consumer and giving consumers more access to credit and more access to better offers with credit as well, lower rates, things like that. So there's a human impact to everything that we're doing with these solutions.